Could be this as well. Actually, probably somewhere like this, isn't it, really? National Heritage. Looks more like that than it would. Yeah, it looks like it'd fit in more with that. So, you know what? I'm not going to waste any more time. Let's go. Welcome back to another Joe Gets a Video. In today's video, we're going to be doing another play along. I haven't done one of these in a little while. And they do alright actually on views, so I thought we'll do another one because people seem to be interested. So we're going to revisit the interesting photospheres in obscure countries. This is quite a hard map, so yeah, this will be quite tough. But before we go into this play along, if you like this sort of content, then be sure to drop a like, and if you're interested in subscribing as well, that'll also be appreciated as well. So yeah, but also just quickly go over the last play along results and have a look. We played the Capitals map. So yeah, GG's to everyone. And not as many people play this time, but well done then to Michelle or something like that. Michael, something like that. Sorry for butchering the name there, but yeah, on to the second game. Oh nice, first place. Oh yeah, that, I think that was a bugged out room, wasn't it? We all got 0 points. And the last one, yeah, again, GG's. Cracking score on that one. So fair play, GG's. And let's move on to today's play along and see how well we do. I haven't played this map in a little while, so yeah, this will be interesting. Okay, we're doing 2 minutes per round as well, so we don't spend ages on each round. So yeah, let's give this a go. And what's the first one? I don't think we're quite ready to play tough this map's gonna be. Okay, it looks quite Mediterranean, just in by the landscape and everything. Next to the sea. The sun's not gonna help, that's the thing as well with this map. I'm not sure if we can trust the compass, or which range we can trust the compass, so yeah, it'll be a bit difficult with that aspect. But yeah, as I said, looks Mediterranean. Any other? Yeah, I mean, I'm not the best with architecture. I'm not sure what that pole is there. I haven't seen that before, so that's not going to help. Does it look volcanic at all? Like trying to find, is any like black soil or anything? Because I was thinking Canaries, but I mean it could be with them mountain cities, with the landscape. Could be something like the Canaries, but I'm not sure if that would. I suppose it's rare to get Canaries on GeoGuessr, but then it is part of Spain, which is an obscure country, so we could lean away from there, I guess. So Mediterranean, I'd say yeah, Mediterranean. An obscure Mediterranean country. So which countries don't really get that often? So let's say if the compass is right, which maybe not. It could be like north of Morocco, possibly. That could be an option. You know what I mean? Though, as I said, I'm not the best at architecture, so this might be a clue down here, but I'm not exactly great. Some architecture I can get a feel for, but some like something like this I'm not great with. So it could be somewhere, in case it is Canaries, I'm just going to go north of Morocco here. Because as I said, it doesn't mind me Mediterranean, but let's see. Oh, it was just in Algeria. So you know what, I'll take that. That's actually a decent guess. Knew it was somewhere around here, just as I said, Mediterranean. Just the next country over. So I'm happy with that actually. Morocco was a decent guess. So that's a good guess. Not bad start off. Okay. Okay, so we've got Arabic, I think. I think that should be the language. Obscure country. We are jumping on the right as well, so that should narrow it down a little bit, I guess. You got any clues here? Lian real estate. I'm not familiar with that. That's a state or a place or something. With these yellow and black curbs, I'm just trying to think. I know a few countries use these, but I'm not sure on the obscure countries that do. These characters look quite Ethiopian, but nah, can't be. So you have a little blue strip there. Is that a European strip? It is. That's a bit confusing. Don't think it would be. I mean, possibly. We'd have a blue strip. drawing right hand side of the road. So with this language, as I say, it looks right in this area here. Because we've got Lebanon, possibly. I think they're drawing the right, but I can't say for certain. Cyprus wouldn't fit. So it could fit something like Iran, Iraq. I don't think it's over here. And as I said, we do seem to have a slight blue strip, but I don't know if that's a European thing or not. European strip. So I'm going to guess somewhere in Lebanon here, I think. And I don't think it's the capital. It doesn't give me that vibe. So I'm just going to guess in Tripoli. It was Iran. So maybe that probably wasn't an EU strip then. So I was getting a bit confused by that. So there must be a feature on some of the Iranian number plates. But still, that's not a bad guess. That's in the right region, in the right ballpark. Iran was one of my options. So I suppose looking back, it didn't quite look like Lebanon. But again, not a bad guess. That's not bad. Okay. Oh, I didn't want to look at this, but Nuuk Street View, which is the capital of Greenland. So I didn't really want that to be a giveaway, but I suppose if you look at here, actually does look quite, yeah, the snow and the houses, the buildings here, yeah. I suppose if you look at the language as well, yeah, it looks like around that part of the world. I probably would have guessed somewhere like Greenland, maybe Faroe Island or something if I didn't see Nuuk Street View there, but we are in Nuuk, or Nuuk, whatever you pronounce it. And we're in some sort of building here. Maybe we're in this University of Greenland. It's a possibility. Liam's Spiral. Could be something like that as well. That would make sense because it's the photosphere. That would make sense with the image, with the photo icon there. So maybe we should guess there because that would make most sense. Could be this as well. Actually, probably somewhere like this, isn't it, really? National Heritage looks more like that than it would. Yeah, it looks like it'd fit in more with that. So, you know what? I'm not going to waste any more time. Let's go for that. Oh, it was the Art Museum. I didn't quite see that. If I spent more time looking, then I probably would have guessed there. But, yeah, I didn't quite look in far enough. But still, could have got 5k on that. But not to stress, it's only a play along, so we don't need to sweat, do we, really, too much. We don't need to worry about it that much. So again, we're in the Arabic part of the world, I think. Yellow plate as well. That's interesting. It would be helpful if I knew which Arabic country use yellow plates. That would be useful. Ooh, what's this? I'm just trying to zoom in and see what matches with this sort of text. So it doesn't quite fit for Iraq. Have we not seen any of those dots? Oh, we do a little bit, actually. Yeah, those squiggles there actually could fit in with Iraq. Because, yeah, we have a little a few dots above the letters as well. Could fit with Iran. I mean, they do look quite similar, but it looks quite like Iraq. Syria? It would be very helpful if I knew yellow plates in this part of the world. I'm not sure if I can make what that is out there on that sign. It could be Syria as well. I'm thinking like Syria or Iraq here. I don't think the architecture really matches with places down here, like Yemen and Oman doesn't quite fit for me. It could be just Saudi Arabia, to be fair, as well. Definitely part of the world. So, yeah, maybe I'll find out which, well, in a bit I'll find out for sure which these countries use yellow plates. But I'm just going to guess in Iraq, I think. I think that's probably the best bet. Afghanistan. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it was a toss-up really, wasn't it? Again, it was kind of a toss-up between some of these countries. Let me know in the comments below if that's a thing then, if Afghanistan do use yellow plates, or if that's just a one-off, or if any other countries nearby that do, let me know if you know. And yeah, again, it's not a bad guess by all means. Oh God. Okay, we're on the bird's eye view here. In the middle of absolutely nowhere. So my first thought was just somewhere really in Russia. The sun would be in the north. But I don't know if we can trust the compass on this. I don't know if we can. The road, yeah. The road would kind of fit for somewhere in Russia, but this honestly could be anywhere. Just want to know if we're drawing the left or the right. Let's park there, but it's not really clear. I don't think he's driving, he just parks. So. I mean, we're on for an okay score here. It's respectable for this map. It's very flat. Very flat. Well, I do wonder where this is. As I said, my first thought was somewhere in Russia, but kind of would fit with that, I guess. But I'm kind of worried in case it is Southern Hemisphere, with the North Sun being the south in the north. But I don't know if we can trust that. It was Southern Hemisphere. I'm just trying to think where it'd be. It's too green for somewhere like Australia, New Zealand. Too flat as well. Wouldn't fit South Africa. Wouldn't really fit South America either, I don't think it would. I mean, maybe somewhere rural in Brazil, but I don't quite get that vibe. It's too flat as well, it's very flat, so I'm just going to get something in Russia. I think that's probably the best bet, really. Honestly, as I said, this could be absolutely anywhere. I know it just get quite mountainous over here, so I'm going to try and pick a flatter part if I can. Maybe somewhere near Tomsk. It was Southern Hemisphere. I wasn't sure if we could trust the compass. I know, it was actually just in the Northern Hemisphere. But again, I don't know if the compass was right or wrong. I didn't know Suriname was actually that flat. I think it was quite green and foresty, but it didn't quite come to mind. Also, I suppose it is a map for obscure countries. So it kind of done me in there. I didn't quite think that through. But yeah, kind of messed up on the last one, but still a respectable score. Still a respectable score. Yeah, I kind of guessed the obscure country for the rest, is just the last one. Just nothing was really coming to me. So, yeah. Let's go for one more game, though, and try and remember the obscure countries that you don't spawn in GeoGuess very often. So, play one more game. Kind of funny, I guess, Russia for that. Probably one of those, like, not obscure countries. But, okay, is this bugged? Okay, this is another bug location, unfortunately. So let's guess somewhere. Nepal. Not safe to be done. Yeah, I mean, bug location, what can you do? Okay, I thought that was gonna be bugged for a second there. Okay, this should be China, just on first glance. And obviously China would be part of this map because you don't hardly ever get it in GeoGuessr, because it doesn't really have any official coverage. Wouldn't think that for the last round of the last game. Oh well. But yeah, I guess it would be China. Unless Hong Kong is a possibility. Or Macau. But I am just going to guess. It reminds me a little bit of Shanghai. So I'm just going to guess Shanghai in China. As I said, it could be any big Chinese city or Hong Kong. But let's just go with that. Otherwise, I'm going to have to think it. So. Was China, Sihan, don't know how to pronounce that, but I mean, yeah, it reminded me of Shanghai, so I wasn't really gonna get anything else from that. So, on to the third round. Okay, we have blue on the bottom and the top. Doesn't really help because I don't know that. Ooh. Okay, we do have English. I'll say a dark bag name though. Good. Dear me. Can't see a domain. But I assume we are in Africa. Because the ethnicity and the people, we speak in English. And it just kind of reminds me of Africa, I guess. unless it's somewhere on the, like, the Caribbean or Pacific Island, but I don't, can't see that. Okay, so it's, I'm gonna rule out like this part of Africa here. It looks a bit too, it's not deserty enough for that. Looks like it'd be more inland. Or maybe slightly towards the east, I'm not sure. Honestly, it could be somewhere like Central African Republic. Cameroon. They have, I think they have orange plates, so that would rule out Cameroon. Blue on the top and the bottom. I really hope I'm not missing any standard clues here. Would help if we draw, yeah, we got to draw on the right. Yeah, we are. So, could be somewhere like Democratic Republic of Congo. Could be anywhere. I think it's more Central Africa, I do. I'm just going to go for Central African Republic. Oh, ruled out. That's annoying. I thought I'd rule out all the African countries on the west coast. See, as I said, it kind of didn't give me that vibe. It was quite green and it wasn't quite deserty enough. But then Liberia, actually, I did forget about that. That can get very green. And a bit of Sierra Leone as well. But the rest of this part of Africa is quite deserty or not as green. But yeah, Liberia makes sense. We were speaking English. And I think, do we speak English in Central African Republic? Probably a mixture of languages, to be honest. It looks more French. So that was kind of a miss there. But still, I don't know Africa in and out. So I thought Central African Republic spoke a bit of English as well. Okay. Vertop. Sharp. This reminds me of, no, it can't be because it's not, it needs to be an obscure country, Harry, come on. It kind of reminds me of like the mountains bordering Poland and Slovakia, but yeah, they wouldn't be obscure countries. July und Einzig, okay, German. Oh, okay, I think this actually could be Liechtenstein, thinking about it, because it's an obscure country. The more I look at it, actually reminds me of the Alps. And I think this country, like the layout actually, I think that might be Vaduz, the capital down there. I do think I've nailed it, because you're speaking German as well, judging off that. So I actually do think we're in Liechtenstein here. As you can see, mountains on both sides here. And Vaduz is like a kind of a valley, really. It's kind of, yeah, I do think that's right. I do think that's right. So maybe I should guess, yeah, maybe something like that, actually. That would make sense. I think I'm quite, yeah. I mean, didn't quite get the full 5k, but still, pretty much on the border with Austria there. So, good planning, good thinking. After I figured out it was speaking German and looked like it was in the Alps. So, happy with that one. Okay, on to the final round. Oh, we have a domain there or not? Looks like a TL, but I don't know if that's a domain or just a company name. Interesting. So we have that and English. Right, just trying to narrow this down. Mandu College. I'm kind of thinking this is Pakistan because we have a lot of English as well. Anything on here? No. We have all the lot of British universities there. So just a bit concentrated here, but looks like we're drawing on the left as well. Looks like it. But it might be able to follow this road. No, looks like we are. It does look like we are. Could it be India? It could be India. But I'm leaning more Pakistan. It's just this language that's kind of throwing me off, and I don't see that too often. Yeah, it kind of fits more with Pakistan than it would India. It could be Afghanistan again, but with Pakistan, I associate that with, you know, speaking more English. So we could go for the capital. We could go for something like Lahore. Multan. I'm going to guess in centrally. More centrally. Oh. Right. Interesting. Maldives. That's a tough round. I was in the right ballpark, to be fair, with like this part of Asia, but let me know in the comments if you would have got that, if there's any standout clues. Maybe that language was a bit unique and that was throwing me off. Maybe you only really see that sort of text in the Maldives. Let me know, or yeah, because I'm not sure how I could have got that, unless I did miss something. But I don't think Pakistan was even a bad guess, really, considering what we have to work with. So yeah, I'll take that. That's not too bad. Not as good on this game, but this is a tricky map. Even for experienced players, this is, you know, you're getting countries that you don't usually get in GeoGuessr, so it's, you're learning different metas or different landscapes, different, you know, different vibes of a country, basically. So yeah, you're learning a whole different thing. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. So it's been a while since I played this map, but let me know if you want to see more. Next video, I will get back onto the content challenge because I've done that in a little while. And I keep, yeah, so I'm gonna go back onto that. And the next video, I'll probably do my first weekend series in the new competitive scene on GeoGuessr. Get back on that. So hope you did enjoy, and I'll see you for the next video very soon. Sorry, it's been a bit of a delay recently, but I'll try and get back on it a little bit more. So yeah, see you later.